Hi, I'm Sharon, owner and head trainer of At Your Service Dog Training, and I'm going to give you a few tips on lower stress harnessing. So the first thing that can reduce your dog's stress is to have a harness that's comfortable and fits well and doesn't have to go on over their head in some cases. You could also use one that dogs step in, but my favorite is the Balance Harness by Blue Nine. The buckle neck version, which doesn't have to go over their head, you can clasp it on the side of their neck. So this is what it looks like when it's on the dog. What I like about it is that there's a clip that you can attach the leash on to the chest loop, so it doesn't cut across the shoulders and affect their gait, and also it protects their throat, unlike with a collar if they're pulling, and it reduces pulling somewhat because it is on the chest. And then there's also a loop on the back that you can use if you're, say, tethering your dog or they're running on a long line, dragging a long line or something like that. And it's adjustable at every place on the around the neck and the chest and the rib cage. So it fits a lot of different sizes and types of dogs. And if you're working with us here in Hadley, you can get one from me. You can also order them online. I'll put a link in the text under the video. Or you can order it from Clean Run in South Hadley. Either go there in person or order it online. And all of these tips that I'm giving you also apply to if you're using a vest for your service dog. My favorite vest is from the Raspberry Field because they're lightweight and comfortable and get zipper pockets. So those are a good multi-purpose vest. My favorite thing with most of the service dog teams I work with is to have the balance harness on. That's where you attach your leash, and then the vest goes on top of it for identification and if you want your dog, service dog, to carry, you know, some small things in the pockets. This is Kismet, my standard poodle. He's going to be our demo dog. So now I'll show you how to make it less stressful to put the harness on your dog. So one thing to be aware of is what dogs do find stressful, and that is to put the harness on so you're sort of looming over them like this. A lot of, I'm just patting him to make it more pleasant, although he's a very mellow dog about handling. A lot of dogs don't like it if you do this. And then also a lot of dogs, if you're putting it on the side and you're sort of looming over them and doing this, a lot of dogs really don't like that too. So we're gonna try to avoid that in our harnessing. So the first thing is, if your dog already has a negative association with your harness, get a new harness. Keep using the old one for now as you need to walk them while you're building a positive association with the new one. To make a positive association with the new harness, you're going to show it to them and then make a treat party happen. Kismet, up, up. I'm going to demo this with Kismet up here just to make it, I want you all the way up, up, up. Just to make it easier on my back and for you to see. So what I would do is I would take out the harness and show it, good boy, and then I would praise and give a lot of delicious treats. Drop down, good boy. So your dog learns, I see this thing and good stuff happens. Then you put it away, the treats and the praise stop, and then you bring it out again. Oh, good boy, yes, good job. So that's what you start with. You do this over and over until your dog looks really happy when they see their harness. And then the next step that you can use is if you want, and your dog already knows how to nose target something, you could have them do that. In some cases, you could skip the step. It really depends, a lot depends on the dog. So it's a good idea to start getting yourself used to how all the pieces fit together, so when you do start to harness them, you're prepared for that. So you can hold it out and do touch, yes. And then when your dog nose targets it, they get a treat. I'm just gonna rotate them so you can see them a little bit more easily. So I'm gonna hold it out, touch, yes. So that's the next step. So we're just building positive associations with the new harness. All right, here, kiss. It's easier for him to fit on one sitting. Thank you. Touch. Yes. Okay. So you do that a bunch, and then you can either have your dog up on a raised surface, like this climb is also from Blue Nine, or you can have them do a pause up, which I'll show you in a minute, or you can just have them do a sit, and you're going to crouch down next to them. So then what you're going to want to do is to have them, is you're going to touch them at the same time with your hand, at the same time as they're seeing the harness. So I'm going to just do that, yes, and then treat. So your dog gets used to all the stuff that comes up before the harnessing. So I'm going to crouch down as if I'm going to harness, touch, yes. Because sometimes it's that first touch that kind of makes them jump. When your dog is comfortable with that, then when you're harnessing, you always want to come in from the side, not moving over, not coming from the front. And I'm also going to show you at the end how I'm making the clasps not make that loud, awful sound that they make. So I'm going to come in from the side. I'm going to touch him first so he's prepared. You can see he was sort of leaning away because I hadn't done that. I'm going to close the clasp quietly. Yes, good job. I'm going to give a treat after each component. I'm going to come in from the side again to do the pieces that come from underneath. Yes, good boy. Give a treat. Good job. Then I'm going to again come from underneath here and do the last one. Yes. So that's how you can do it if your dog is sitting. There's also a method that you can do, which I do with him, which is his favorite, of doing a pause up on it. And that looks like this. Pause. Yes. So this is his favorite way. A lot of dogs like this method too. I'm just going to quickly take this off. Yes. So you can see what that looks like. So I have him do a pause up. I get all the pieces ready. I'm going to come in and touch him. Hello. So he's prepared. And if he was not used to this, I would also be treating a lot at every tiny little step. I have other videos that show the treating. Yes, good boy. Good job. Sweet. And then we're done with that. So to show you how to make the clasps not have that loud sound, I'm just going to use this collar here. So if you've got a quick release buckle like this, you're going to put your fingers over the holes on the quick release buckle, and then when you put it in like that, it's quiet, which a lot of dogs and people appreciate. Hope this is helpful. Happy training.